Welcome to another Visser episode. Today, we're going to see what the research says about weight loss and what's the most effective way to do it. And this is basically to fine-tune what you're doing and how to keep your metabolism good, how to lose weight without losing muscle mass, because that's the big no. And so we're going to go through it. We're going to go through what you need to do with energy intake, which is the number one, what you need to do with your protein intake. It's number two. And what type of exercise? Is it resistance? Is it cardio? Is it circuit training that gives you the best results? So I don't want you just going in neutral and not being able to lose weight. I want you to really know what the science is saying about it and the most effective way of doing this. So let's get going. Let's dive in. Number one that we have to go through is your energy intake has to be lower. So you have to lower the amount of food and liquids with calories that you're intaking, okay? By 100 kilocalories if you want a specific number. But it basically means cut out the sugars, cut out some of the carbs, the bad carbs, bread, rice, that kind of stuff. Just limit that. Make the least amount of changes to give you the results you're looking for, okay? So when we're looking at this, I want you to focus on no sugars, drop your no snacks, no chips, none of that artificial food, highly processed foods, cut that out. And then really focus on having that energy deficit throughout, okay? Next thing you want to do is increase your protein intake. This is a must. And so where does our protein intake needs to be? It needs to be about 1.6 to 1.8 grams per kilogram of ideal body weight. So you can calculate that. It means just up your protein. And it will do different things for you, which we'll go through. The next thing is resistance training. So training with weights, training with resistance for an hour is more effective and efficient than aerobic exercise. Science-based. And the big mistake we've always made is like, let's go jogging, let's go run, let's go walk, let's go do all this cardio stuff. And we're seeing it's less effective. Now, it's less effective in different ways and there's nuances. So we're looking at, you can do it with cardio, okay? I'm not saying you can't do it with cardio, but if you wanna be more efficient in how you do it, you need to resistance train, all right? And we're gonna go through what this all means. Okay, so acute energy expenditure, meaning the energy that you go, is slightly lower with weight training than aerobics. Okay, so someone will tell you, no, that's not true. When you're doing aerobics, you're expending more energy than with weight training. True, to a certain extent. We're talking about if you're doing cardio, it's 200 to 600 kilocalories that you're burning, and weights, 300 to 500 calories that you're burning. So there's a slight difference. Yeah, cardio ekes out. But this is the thing. When you stop cardio, everything stops. With weight training, it keeps going for days. You're actually burning for days. And why? Resistance training, one, increases oxygen uptake, right? This is during and after training. And so what you also have is that with resistance training, you get remodeling and repair of the muscle and you get muscle growth. And this continues for days after. So your calories keep counting up. So in the end, much more efficient to do weight training than it is to do cardio. Now, circuit training is also a good idea. HITs, not that good, because the problem with HITs is you can't get an hour in. You're gonna be dead before an hour of HITs. Okay, so HITs is short term. We need you in there an hour, okay, a day or three times a week, whatever you choose to do. Minimum is three times a week. I want you in there an hour, all right? I don't want you in there less than that. Then the key is then add up. You need to take a little more. You want a little more off, then put cardio after, okay? So do 30 minutes of zone two brisk walking, uphill walking, or whatever you want. That is the key. And why do we do this? Because this is the thing. When you go on a calorie deficit diet, you're going to start losing weight. But there's two components that make you lose weight. One is your body's eating your muscle, and the other is your body is using fat. When your body starts using the muscle, fat loss stops, meaning the fat actually doesn't. These are two different mechanisms. So it'll, you know, omit the fat reduction and go into the muscle. We don't want that because we know with age you lose muscle mass goes, and we need it when we age. We need it. We work hard to keep our muscle mass, and we need it. So you need to lose weight without losing muscle mass. And the key there is weight training. All right, resistance training. Doesn't have to be, could be with body weight, but it needs to be resistance training. You need to get those muscles going with resistance. Okay, now in itself, muscle mass increase. So if you actually gain some muscle, you get a 5% added bonus. You get 5% more energy released throughout the day. Okay, walking around. Now, if you go from sedentary lifestyle to increasing muscle mass and doing resistance training, it's actually 20% more just during the day, how much you're losing. All right. The other thing is, let's talk about the protein intake. Protein intake is critical because it's protein synthesis. That's one, meaning your muscles need protein to come in. So we need your protein high. Secondly, with protein intake, you have satiety. Also with strength training. So with strength training, you actually have satiety. It means you're not that hungry. If you're doing a bunch of aerobic stuff, you're going to be hungrier. You're going to be wanting to eat more. Same thing with protein. If your protein intake goes up, you're not going to feel that hungry. It's going to feel like you're full for longer, all right, with less calories. So these are key things. These will help you with your energy balance, with keeping that energy deficit going. Okay, so the reason I'm going over like time limits. I want your time limit to be an hour, and then you can do 30 minutes of zone 2 cardio afterwards, is because there is the law of diminished returns. And that means after a certain point, let's say you're doing cardio and you're saying, man, I need to lose more weight, so I'm going to do 2 hours. Listen, after an hour, the returns on what you're doing is starting to minimize. Okay, your body is just tired. It's over. It's not going to utilize the fat. It's just going to be like, you know, winding down. So we really want to be in the zone where we're using as much energy as possible and energy from fat. So we want to get rid of fat, okay? Visceral fat and subcutaneous fat, okay? So that's the key there. The other thing that we want to do is if you're doing a circuit session, that's good too. So very little time in between sessions, and you'll do an hour of circuit training with weights and with resistance. This is also effective. So you can also opt for that and then include, of course, your zone two. What we want to do here is basically, you know, when we're decreasing your calories daily, and it's not much, so it's what you can handle, all right? It's not like huge decreases, because I want your weight loss to go slowly, 1 pound a week, something like that, 1.5 pounds a week. Slowly, long term. You got to think about 6 months. I want to be there in 6 months. I want to be there. I want to be to my fighting weight at that point. I want you to really go slow with this, because that'll help you. And I don't want you to do anything that is not sustainable. So if you're going into real energy deficit, if you're really cutting down on everything, then it's not going to be sustainable, and you're not going to make it. It's just going to, you're going to blow up after a while and just start eating again, and you're going to just blow back up. So I don't want you to do that. I want you to go steady, Freddy, slow. All right. Also, remember that the most dangerous calories are the one in liquids. Okay. So if you're doing sodas, if you're doing anything with sugar in it, any alcohol, that's going to bring in calories that you don't feel. They don't fill. You're still going to eat after it or eat with it. Right. You're not going to feel them, but your calorie count is going to shoot up. All right. Drop the alcohol. Do it once a week, whatever, but drop it. Okay, that's a big one. The other thing that I think is very beneficial in this is time-restricted feeding. And this is something that you might want to do. And that is, and it's good for your health, and it's really good to maintain your body weight. And that means doing 7 hours or 8 hour feeding window. So let's say I start eating at 12, that's my first meal. And I stop eating at 7, that's it. All right, the rest of the time I'm drinking water, I'm drinking tea, I'm drinking coffee, no sugar added. All right, that's it. So in those 7 hours, what happens is you're able to control your calorie consumption more. If you're eating during the day, if you're continually feeding yourself, you're gonna lose calorie count. And I don't want you counting calories, but it's just a simpler way to basically drop that 500 kilocalories that you want a day off your normal consumption of calories. So that's a good tip to have in there, all right? So I want you to really focus on that. Let's summarize. You have to restrict your energy intake, meaning your feeding has to come down. And you can do that with intermittent fasting or time-restricted feeding that I just explained. And just start eliminating some of the stuff that doesn't hurt you, okay? So the sugars, some of the carbs that you might be consuming, potatoes and breads and pasta, that kind of stuff. Start moving that out. Sauces, watch out with sauces. If you're someone that likes, I like sauces. Sauces come with a lot of calories, so watch it, okay? Better to use some lemon, some olive oil, good fats, that's okay, all right? So the other thing is increase your protein intake, and that should be around 1.8 grams per kilogram of body weight. Women and men, this goes for both sides. Cardio is only beneficial if first you do resistance training. So if you do strength training first, either with your body weight or weights in a gym, if you're doing that first, then you do a little bit of cardio after, like half an hour of zone two, which means brisk walking, it's beneficial, all right? You will have times that you plateau. Don't worry about it. Increase your cardio a little bit, increase your change, your workout up a little bit, and you'll see it comes down. This is normal. Your body wants to set. Your body has a set metabolism. It wants to keep you at a certain weight. Now you're dropping that weight and it feels unnatural. So that's why I want you to take it slow so your body can get used to it. So you trick your body to a certain extent. And we want to bring our body to a new normal, which is lower than it is now. Okay, so that's the key. So there you have it. I'm going to have post research up. We're going to have a couple of papers up. This is the latest research. It's something I've been preaching a long time, but really now we're also seeing it in the research backed up 100%. So let's get to it. Let's drop that weight. We need to drop it. We need to be at our fighting weight because that is where our body heals. That's where we are at our best. That's where we're protecting our organs. We're caring for our longevity. We're caring for our health span. It's the key. So bring that weight down at any age. All right? Thank you. Subscribe, ring the bell notification, get your friends to follow. Let's get this going.